Hello friends, welcome once again to my next video tutorial on Java for Beginners. In my last video, we have seen how to handle exceptions using try catch and finally blocks in Java. Now, in this video, we will discuss some more important points to handle exception and what are the other ways to handle exceptions in Java. In my last video, we have seen that we can use a try catch block something like this, and this is the code which throws an arithmetic exception because any integer which is divided by 0 will give an infinity, right? Now, in this same try catch block, we can add multiple catch blocks like this. Means we can handle multiple exceptional situations. Okay, for example, I am catching this exception, arithmetic exception, and we want to handle one more exception, which is the general kind of exception. We don't know what kind of exception is this. We don't know whether it is an arithmetic exception or some other type of exception. So I will say this is a general exception. Okay, and then in here I am going to print this E object, and apart from that also I want to print to check which catch block is executed. In the case of other exceptions rather than arithmetic exception, this catch block is going to execute. Okay, to check this, let's add some more exceptional situations here. So for example, I will declare a string variable, string str equals to hello. This is outside my try catch block, and inside my try catch block, first let me comment this arithmetic exception situation, because at a time only one exception will be raised. And as I am commenting arithmetic exception situation, I will comment these variables also because there is no use right now. Okay, then I want to print the character of fifth index of the string variable. We know that string variable str is having 5 characters and their index will be from 0 to 4th. So fifth index element is out of scope, right? So let's save and run this program. And now we can see this time different exception is throw, and which is caught by this general exception catch block, which has a more priority than arithmetic exception handling catch block. Okay, so this exception, which is the string index out of bounds exception, is handled by this general exception. Okay, so this exception class is a general class. Means if we don't know which exception is thrown by our code, we can use this exception. Otherwise, if we know that our code can throw arithmetic exception or string index out of bound exception or some other type of exception, then we can mention the specific exception name like this one which we have done earlier. Okay, and always remember that we can add multiple catch blocks. Like we can add one catch block, two catch block, or more than that with our one try block. Okay, now let me tell you one more thing. If I want to handle this general exception here before the arithmetic exception like this, then it is going to give this error here, and it says unreachable catch. Why? Because this general exception class has more priority than arithmetic exception, so this should come at the last. Okay, so just put general exception catch block below the arithmetic exception catch block here. Then we can see my error will be gone. So always remember, this general exception class should go at the last. Okay, and other exceptions like arithmetic exception or any index out of bound or some other type of exceptions will be above it because they have the lesser priority. Okay, understood. So based on this discussion, please remember some important points. An exception can be handled using try, catch and finally blocks. It is possible to handle multiple exceptions using multiple catch blocks. Even though there is possibility of several exceptions in try block, at a time only one exception will be raised. A single try block can be followed by several catch blocks. Generally, exception class has more priority than arithmetic exception, so this should come at the last. We cannot write a catch without a try block, but we can write a try without any catch block. It is not possible to insert some statements between try and catch. It is possible to write a try block with another try. They are called nested try blocks. Finally, block is always executes whether exception occurs or it does not occurs. That we can see here in this program. There is no exception in try block. If we run this program, this message finally block is called is displaying. That means this finally block is always executed without any exception. There is only one situation where this finally block will not be called, and this situation is when we call a system.exit method inside try catch block. For example, I will write this system.exit with some integer value here, and when I run this code, we can see finally block is not called and this message is not printed. Why? Because we have called system.exit and it exit from the program, and this is the only situation where this finally will not be called. Okay, finally will be executed even if you are returning from the try block or even from the catch block. To understand this situation in a better way, let's create a method, and this method only return integer. In this method, we have same try catch block. Okay. And in the main method, we pass these two values, 10 and 5 in division method. So this variable t value is a divided by b, means 10 divided by 5, which is equal to 2. So it is valid situation and we want to return t value, right? So in the try block, we will return t value, and if it throws an exception, then it goes to catch block. So we will return t value here also in catch block. Now let's run the program and let's see what happens. It returns 2, which is printed here. Because of this system.out.println statement. And then finally block is called after the try block. So we can see here, even if function returns some value, then also finally block will be called. Okay. Apart from that, there is one more situation which can occur. If I want to return from the finally block also. So for example, right now value of t is equal to 2 because we are passing 10 and 5 in the division method, right? Then in the finally block, I want to override my return value. For example, I will return 10. Okay. And let's run the program and we'll see what happens. If we see, it returns 10. So we can see that finally overrides return value also. Okay, so ideally it should return 2 if we are not returning from finally, right? But it returns 10 like this because we return from finally block. Okay, it means finally will be override our earlier return value, which was 2. So this is all about handling runtime or unchecked exceptions, which is handled by JVM. We know that even if we are not handling runtime exceptions, the Java compiler will not able to find any error at compile time. We will only come to know about unchecked exceptions in runtime by JVM, and that we need to handle using try catch block that we have already discussed. So we can say Java compiler allow us to write a Java program without handling the unchecked exceptions and errors, but not JVM. In case of check exception, Java compiler able to find any error and it will not allow us to write a Java program without handling. So Java compiler expects that we should handle the exception using try and catch block, or else we should throw out the exception without handling it. If we will not do this, we will get compile time error. Means the rule is that we should also handle check exceptions. So we should throw it out check exceptions using throws clause. What is throws clause? Throws in Java, which is used in the signature of method to indicate that this method might throw one of the listed type of exceptions. The caller of these methods has to handle the exceptions using a try catch block. Means when we define a method and we know that some part of code can raise an exception. For example, in this method, we know that there is a chance of exception if b value is 0. And we don't want to handle that exception within that method, then that method is defined with throws keyword. So for that, we can add throws keyword here. And after throws keyword, we need to add exception type. In our case, we need to add arithmetic exception, right? When another method, main method, wants to use division method, we need to call that division method in try block and a catch block should be used to handle that exception. Okay, if we run this program, we are able to see this message: code is executed. It means our program is run properly, and as we are passing b value is 0 in division method in try block, and we will get exception in division method because 10 divided by 0 becomes infinity. So we need to throw exception from this method, and after that we need to handle this exception in catch block. And in here we are just simply print the exception. Okay, so this is all about throws clause. Now we will talk about one more keyword, that is throw, not throws. So what is throw? The throw keyword in Java is used to explicitly throw an exception from a method or any block of code. We can throw either check or uncheck exceptions. The throw keyword is mainly used to throw custom exceptions. Means if user define its own exceptions by extending the exception class, then that exception can be raised by only using throw keyword. That we can see in this example also. We can just simply throw this user defined exception in division method if b value is 0. So here we are displaying the user defined exception like this way. We should not divide number by 0. Understood? So this is all about exception handling. I hope you enjoyed this video. So request you to please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.